50 years ago today, the blues singer Leadbelly died, but his music lives on and has influenced a host of musicians, from Van Morrison to Lonnie Donegan and Ronnie Woods. So Newsnight asked these three major stars to play together in an exclusive concert for Newsnight. To celebrate Leadbelly's legacy, Robin Denzel was lucky enough to get front row seating at this special gig.
The 100 Club in London's Oxford Street has played a key role in British pop music. And here this afternoon there was a historic meeting of veteran British musicians. Chris Barber, a leading figure in the trad jazz movement of the 50s. Lonnie Donegan, once a member of Barber's band and as king of the 50s skiffle boom, the biggest British star of the era. The legendary Van Morrison and Ronnie Wood from the Rolling Stones.
Well, I wake up in the morning, hear the ding dong ring.
Together at a special session for Newsnight to pay tribute to a black American folk singer who died 50 years ago today, but thanks to Donegan, played a key role in British pop history. His name was Leadbelly, and this was one of his songs.
If you ever go to Houston, Lord, you better walk right. You better not stack on, and you better not find all the sheriff gonna arrest you.
So why was Leadbelly so special?
And if the jury find it guilty, you better touch your rebound.
The voice, the whole thing, the songs, the voice, everything. Just the sound. The sound.
It's all individual, highly individual. There's nobody else sounds like Leadbelly. Nobody else plays like the king of the 12-string guitar players of the world, which he undoubtedly was, because nobody, no matter how adept subsequent players have been on the guitar, they've never had the original, indigenous sound, as you might say, of Leadbelly, and they've never had the attack and the swing of Leadbelly. The dynamism of him on the guitar.
It got a money, I can pick and feel the cut. It got a money, I can pick and feel the day. It got a money.
Huddie Leadbetter, far better known as Leadbelly, was born sometime in the late 1880s and rambled across the southern states, an itinerant worker famous for his vast repertoire of songs and serious brushes with the law. He was jailed for murder, then attempted homicide, but got early release thanks to his singing. In his final years, he became a hero of the left-wing folk scene and a friend of Pete Seeger, who recorded his songs.
Well, I looked at my partner. Well, 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 he was almost dead.
Now 80, Pete Seeger remembers him well.
An extremely muscular man. If he hadn't been a musician, he would have been a prize athlete. I met him when I was a teenager, and he was in his 50s, and he moved light on his feet like a prize fighter.
He spent much of his time in jail. He'd got in trouble with the law.
Well, when he was young, he got in trouble. Of course, you know, in those places he played, it was like the Wild West 100 years ago. And if there was a fight, you didn't call the police. You defended yourself to the death.
It's a road to ride, road to rock on a line. It's a mighty good road. If you want to ride, you got to ride it like you're fine. Get your ticket at the station.
Part of Leadbelly's repertoire was the story of a train driver outside New Orleans cheating at a toll booth on the Rock Island line.
Hold your Rock Island line, it's a mighty good road. Hold your Rock Island line, it's a road to ride.
Lonnie Donegan and Chris Barber sang their version, along with other American folk songs, at jazz concerts in the mid-50s, using backing from guitar, bass and washboard to give other band members a break. They called the style skiffle, but their record company was not initially impressed.
Chris had to lean very heavily on the good offices of the producer in order to allow us to do vocals on it. Didn't want to know.
They didn't want it recorded.
Wasn't interested at all. He said, no, he said, I've I've bought a jazz album here. It's, well, that's not jazz, all that shit the kids singing, you know.
You didn't make any money from it?
No, not a penny. Well, not a penny. I got musicians' union singers' fee, which was £3.5. And that's it.
The Rock Island Line was first released on an album in 1954, but didn't appear as a single until 2 years later. It was a massive hit. Donegan went solo, the skiffle boom was underway.
And that one song changed the face of British pop music. Here was a new, exhilarating DIY style that literally anyone could play. And by the end of 1956, there were an estimated 1,000 skiffle groups in London alone, playing in bars and clubs like this one. Some of those involved went on into folk music and blues, others into rock and roll. Back in the States, the left-wing folk community were somewhat nonplussed that a brash populist like Donegan had made a huge hit with Leadbelly's work, particularly when Donegan went on to record novelty songs like My Old Man's a Dustman. But Donegan and Leadbelly with Rock Island Line had launched British pop music.
It was a pleasure when Lonnie came along and popularised it, and, you know, he set the whole mould.
Give us all a job.
Yeah. Start this all off.
Looking back at that song now, the Rock Island Line from 56 when the single came out, what did that really do to British music?
It sped up. It sped it up greatly. Because the song used to start slow, and by the end it was Rock Island Line, isn't that a man? It was really fast at the end. But but what it did, it just tore down a few barriers that were previously there with all your Perry Comos and all that kind of thing.
That's four chords, you can't do that.
No, it's only three, because I don't usually get on. I like to keep the numbers down. Are we ready? Yes. One, two, three, four, go.
Take this hound, take to Canada.
Donegan notched up some 26 hits in 6 years, but faded from fashion with the Beatles era. Now he's back. He's been performing and recording somewhat unexpectedly with Van Morrison, best known for his adventurous, often improvised songs that mix jazz, folk, and a whole range of influences.
It's great because it's, you know, it's the kind of music I love. I still love it, and I really get a kick out of singing with Lonnie as well, you know. He kind of puts an edge on me, you know, he puts me uptight a bit, which is great, because, you know.
Keeps you on your toes.
Exactly, yeah.
The effect of Skiffle on the Stones, for instance, I mean, an influence going way back?
Yeah, well, I think it influenced every band that is still doing anything today, you know.
Today, of course, is the 50th anniversary of Leadbelly's death. Do you think the British music scene would be different if it hadn't been for these songs and the way that Donegan reinvented them in the 50s?
I'd go further than that. I'd say it probably wouldn't have happened at all. Mm-hmm. You know, I'll put my money on that.
Yeah. It was an incredible launching pad. You can't really describe. It's just, it was such a freedom for everybody to sort of, oh, this is a good job, you know.
Yeah.
So that was the crucial song and the crucial moment.
Yeah, and the crucial break for everyone else. He broke a lot of ground and broke the ice and paved the way for us lot to get in and throw our two penneth in, you know.
Hicks, Fozzie, cat's in the cupboard, but he don't see me. Down a rock on the line, she's the money good road. The rock on the line is the road to run. Oh, when the rock on the line, she's the money good road. If you want to fuck the party, get a ride like a fire, get the ticket at the station on the rock on the line.
Play it, baby!
On the Rock Island Line.
A very special tribute to Leadbelly and A Hard Day's Work for Robin Denslow.